Nothing's good, the news is bad.
This is William Eastman, managing partner for GrowthWorks Media and station director for IBGR. One of my jobs is finding great on-air talent, consultants and business owners with presence and a story to tell. We're expanding our broadcast team to represent our four core time zones: North America, Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, and the Philippines, the India subcontinent, and the last of four, United Kingdom, Ireland, Europe, and Africa. If you are a small business consultant or business owner and would like to audition for an on-air slot in our six-hour show cycle, contact the station director, and that is at programming@bgr.network. We will respond to your email within one business day. Thanks for listening, and don't miss this great opportunity to put the world back to work and grow with us. Thanks.
Do you know why your business is different? Why does it exist? And why do your customers care? If you're not sure, we can help. At Crisp & Co., we work closely with you to get to know your business. Together, we'll build a strategy that communicates your brand message to the people who need to know it, your customers. Crisp & Co. exists to challenge normal. We're a full-service, creative, design, and media agency. We trade in innovative ideas, creative content, and strategic communication that gets maximum results and return on your marketing investment. Find us at crisp.co or on all the usual socials. Crisp & Co. Innovate, create, communicate.
Listening to Women of Business Thriving on the IBGR Network. I hope you found the app. Before the break, we were talking about joy and happiness. And I know you're probably wondering, what does this have to do with business? It has a lot to do with business. And I'm going to teach you a little bit about this during week five. So be prepared to listen to that show. Another thing we're going to talk about this season is building networks. So I'm going to be providing network tips and some tools and on ways that you can have virtual, you know, events or attend virtual events so you can network even more. And when you're networking, a lot of times people think, oh, let me go and collect all of these cards. And hey, I have a stack of cards and I networked. No, that is not networking. Networking is building a relationship with people, connecting with them, having conversations with them, not just collecting cards. You want to be intentional about who you let in your space. So when you're going to these events, and we're going to talk a lot about this during, you know, that show, but you're going to these events, you want to, if you can, if it's possible, you want to grab the itinerary. You want to find out who's going to be in attendance so that you can prepare not only knowing who's in the room, who you want to, don't, I won't say pitch to them. No, who you want to form relationships with. So it's very important that you know who's in the room. And virtual events, woo, are awesome. They are a game changer because you can be actually sitting there talking to someone. And guess what? Your computer is right there in front of you. So as you're having these conversations, you can slide over real quick and go to Google, go to LinkedIn and find out even more about them And you can bring things up to them and, you know, just have a conversation. They're like, whoa, they did their research. Guess what? You may not have done any research at all about this particular person. And a lot of the virtual events that I've been going to, and I also host virtual events for people, the platform I use, they have networking to where it's speed networking. And you do not know who is going to pop up on the screen with you. It is amazing. And you can also sit at tables with people. So you're having those conversations that will lead to growth and also collaboration in building more extensions of your business. And we talk a lot about also is you want to have a team. You want that network of people where you can reach out to, because you're not going to know everything. It is impossible. So if you're one who thinks you know, no, you don't know. So it's great to have that pool of people you can, hey, ooh, I have this skill set I need, but I can't perform it in my job, in my company. So let me go over here and, oh, this person would be great to work with me. Yeah, you need to grab people and help. We all need help, and we do not build our businesses alone. So I'm going to say it again. You do not build your business alone. You know, I mentioned about having a nonprofit, but in a nonprofit, the foundation is set so where we can help women grow in their personal lives, grow their businesses, just grow overall. And they know that they have people there that can help them along the way. We don't just say, hey, here are some resources. Now go forth and be great. No. We are there to help. We're there for them. We're growing their businesses with them. We're not leaving them out there to dry. And that's sometimes people just need that support. And so do you. That is why we're here for you. The IBGR Network helping build your business. They're helping us as hosts build our businesses. We're doing it together. And that is why I stress so much about networks and teaming up and collaborating. And ladies, that is something we have to get better at. We can rule the world. I love to sing that song. It's just like, you know, girls rule the world, and you're going to find out we're running a lot of organizations and governing and companies, and we are starting to take over, ladies. And another aspect we're going to be discussing is we're going to provide some business tips for you. And also some comparisons between men and women who lead. And we're going to dig deep into strategic business goals, some strategy steps for you to thrive in your business. And I like the way I titled this one. Ladies, let's get smart about it. And another aspect that we're going to be talking about are some essential tools that women need in their business. I'm a techie at heart by trade, and I'm going to be bringing in some tips that can help you in your business. That might be a great, you know, spinoff show. I can have an entire season on some tools that help you in your business. And another aspect that we're going to be discussing is training your staff. Hiring the right people for productivity. Having the right people on your team is crucial. But you have to know who you are, what you provide, and where your gaps are as well. So when you're filling these positions, you want to know what you're needing. And do they have the potential to fill the gap? And, you know, you have to look at the personality as well. It is funny because I love to talk to people more so now than I did before. But as I'm talking to them, I'm trying to figure out, you know, their ins and outs and if they will fit. Because the company that I run during the day, we have a different pool of people. And they're not the typical IT people. We love to have fun. A lot of IT people are just like, how do I want to say this? they don't have much personality. I'll put it that way. But we do. We love to have fun. We love to just, you know, kick our shoes off and throw stuff on the grill and just cook and have some fun. So when people come in and looking like, yeah, but guess what? We're happy. We are very happy people. And I don't believe there's another team out there that does the same type of work that we do that are as happy as we are. I mean, I'm telling you, the entire department, we are just happy people. And we love our jobs. We love what we do. And we love being there. And we love just being at peace. A lot of us are about to retire soon, but you know, it's just something about being peaceful and still getting the job done. And it is just so calming to me. It's man. Yeah. And yeah, business, happiness, joy, calm, peace. They all go hand in hand. They go together. You have to have it in your business, man. And I said, my eyes closed thinking like, man, it's just peace. Nothing like it. It will also, you know, bring in facts about people, about women, what they're doing out there in other, you know, in all the different various nations and things. So I am very excited for all of this to unfold. I love it. Okay. So we're talking about men and women, the differences. I actually wrote a chapter in a book about the queen bee syndrome. Now, I'm not saying that all women are the same. I'm not saying that all men are the same, but we do have similarities and some differences. There's a lady that works as an astral. She's a leader where I was working, and she just thought that she had to be the only one on top, that no other women can be up there at that level, only her. So she would try and force the rest of us to stay down where we are. And that's just not how we want to be, ladies. We want to get that out of our minds. We don't want to be that way at all. And I'm going to tell you, it was so funny that we sat and had a conversation. And the way she looked at me when I said, you know, you're in this leadership, you know, position, because you know, level one is leadership position. And you don't even know what a leader is. And she looked at me like, how dare you? No, because what you're showing me is not a leader. But it's sad to think that you really think that you are. Yeah. So we're going to take a quick break, and we come right back. We'll go into a little bit more about season 4. And I'm excited to bring it to you.